That's West End Blues the way you hear it on original 78s and early LPs. Now listen how you'll be able to hear this and countless other jazz classics thanks to Time Life Records. West End Blues. What happy memories. And if you notice on that introduction, I told Louis that I didn't want him to make that introduction because he was the type of fellow that sometimes he'd feel like playing and sometimes he wouldn't. And when he didn't feel like playing, you say, Earl, make the introduction. I told him I wasn't going to make nothing like that. So I said, now, if you're going to make this introduction, be sure you're able to do it when we make a public appearance. And he did. A great artist that memorized everything he could play. That was the West End Blues, and it's great for me to reminisce over a tune like that because we had no idea it was going to turn out as good as it did.
Of course, that was the legendary jazz pianist Earl Father Hines, recalling the day when he and his friend Louis Armstrong cut the landmark jazz classic, West End Blues. Now hear Earl Hines as he remembers Bix Beiderbecke, Billie Holiday, Duke Ellington, and other jazz artists whose music you'll hear in Time Life Records' incomparable series of vintage jazz recordings, Giants of Jazz.
Jack Teagarden, and he had a blues heart. Everything he liked to play was in a blues style. He didn't want to make too many notes, but the notes he made made sense. And along with that great organization was Benny Goodman. Can do. Of course, that was Billie Holiday. And she had been given the title of Lady Day because she was a lady of all days. A girl that had an awful lot of personality. She knew what it was to mingle with all of her people came to hear her. And she had a selfish way of getting around town, and she did what she wanted to do, whether bosses liked it or not. She'd walk in the club on 52nd Street there with a couple of dogs, and 2 hours late, they still didn't move. They'd stay there and wait for her. Oh, what a little moonlight can do. There's a lot of ways to look at that when you think of Billie Holiday.
To audition your introductory album to Giants of Jazz, free, for 10 days with no obligation to buy, simply return the accompanying order card and hear vintage jazz as you've never heard it before. Now hear Earl Hines as he remembers Vic Spiderbeck, Billie Holiday, Duke Ellington, and the other great artists he knew so well, and who you'll be able to hear as you've never heard them before through Time Life Records' incomparable new series, Giants of Jazz.
With a guy like Bix, just like Louis, whenever they started to play, they just took over. And Bix was a guy that had a lot of suggestion all of his own, and trumpet players in the early days, like some of our good saxophone players, tried to be as near the human voice as they possibly could. Bix was a guy that also played from the heart and played a little piano, and his reason for being able to play the chord structures that he did is because he played good piano. His style of trumpet playing was always good, and it stayed up until he got to the place where he didn't know what he wanted to play, piano or trumpet. And I liked this trumpet playing, so did everybody else. This is Duke Ellington's Black and Tan Fantasy. Here is a man who is greatly loved by everybody, and my association with him was wonderful because he was a guy that created ideas, and during those years, that was success of any band, was to try to find something different from everybody else. He was a guy that proved to the world that there was something else besides just straight swing. I'm talking of Duke Ellington, and I can't say too much about him. Jack Teagarden, and he had a blues heart. Everything he liked to play was in a blues style. He didn't want to make too many notes, but the notes he made made sense. And along with that great organization was Benny Goodman.